Dun, da, da, da.
Welcome
to episode
20
I'm sorry, just me being me. So welcome, Bri.
Hey, Tim. How you doing, state champ?
How you doing, state champ?
Doing pretty good. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you very kindly. Congratulations on winning your first.
Well, thank you very much. It was handicapped, but I don't think it takes away from it.
It does
I'm
not.
Still pleased.
You won.
I'm a winner.
You're a winner. I wake up in the morning and I piss excellence.
You're a big, hairy American winning machine.
Damn, Skippy.
How's everyone doing? Welcome to Ripping the Rack, episode 20.
We should probably tell them what we are.
Yeah.
We're just big, hairy winning machines.
We are.
We won.
We did.
So, for those of you that don't know, this is Ripping the Rack podcast. I'm your co-host, Tim.
I'm Brian.
And that's my co-host, Brian. He already announced himself.
I always show up early.
He does. He does. Yeah. Good weekend, huh?
It was a good weekend.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Would love to thank the folks at Newport Entertainment Center in fabulous Newport, Maine.
Hey, I'll tell you, other than the power going out because somebody hit a transformer up the road before, you know, right when we were getting ready to warm up, it went smooth.
Yeah, I thought they did a fantastic job.
Did
actually.
They have any breakdowns?
Not that I know of.
I don't think so, no.
Not during our shift, and I mean, we didn't stay, obviously, for the...
For those of you that don't know what we're talking about, we had the Maine State Singles this past weekend. 10-string event for bowling in Newport at NEC.
Yep.
Again, they did a wonderful job hosting. I was pleasantly surprised with the synthetic approaches. They didn't really get all that tacky.
God, no, that was
not like they were before.
They were fantastic. Pins went. It was really odd. Like
the woods odd there.
I left like I'd hammer the head pin and leave like the back row with no wood.
The sidewalls are insane.
But then the next ball or the next box. I'd miss the head pin and
throw a nine drop or a strike.
Nine drop with wood. And then I'd crush the head pin and throw a hammer. And then I'd hit the head pin and leave the 7-10. I mean, it's
but stuff flies all around.
It does.
There.
It does. No, I thought they did a fantastic job. No breakdowns. I thought the pins went honest.
They did as well as they could given the circumstances of the current day and age in the pandemic.
Yep, I thought so.
Doing temperature checks and hand sanitizing on the way in and
congratulations to my co-host. He did win his first Maine State Singles Candlepin Handicap Bowling Tournament.
Well, thank you.
So congratulations. You bowled fantastic all day. I think you were what,
1142 scratch.
So nice job.
Well, thank you. And nice job to you. 1330.
Thank you.
For 10.
Yep.
Not a bad day. And
no.
You don't think you bowled excellent, but that's an excellent score.
I only say that because of the three middle strings, the 6th, 7th, and 8th strings.
Mm-hmm.
Guess that's technically not the middle.
Right.
But
what number state title is that for you for singles?
I can't. Honestly, I was trying to think of it. It's either 5 or 6. I can't remember right off the top of my head.
You won it the last time you bowled in it, didn't you?
Yeah, a couple of years ago.
Yeah, a couple
up
years
in Bangor.
Ago. Yeah.
Won that with a fantastic score of 1222.
Yeah, and I was surprised you beat Evan, honestly.
Oh, Evan's terrible. I mean,
well, he doesn't bowl anymore because he's lazy.
Oh, he's so bad. Oh, God. Hi, Evan.
Hi.
So I'm not going to say I did. I bowled well this weekend. I did. And my score indicates it. But I had the three middle strings that I really struggled in. But I was thinking about it today and I never, the cool part with me is that I shouldn't say the cool part with me. And this is for Sean Dion because, he says, oh, great.
More Tim talking about Tim on Ripping the Rack.
Yeah. Each one of those three strings, I went 119, 104, 116. Each one of those was with a spare or a strike in the last box.
Mm-hmm.
So I was spare strike for the 119. So I was sitting at 99.
Mm-hmm.
I was sitting at 88 in that 104. So it was spare 6. And then in the 114, I think I went spare strike. in that as well.
Nice, nice.
But I ended strong, which, God, I needed to, considering what happened in the fourth shift, the last shift.
Yeah, Cole going nuts.
Cole Fry had a chance to win his first.
Mm-hmm. He's over 13 as well.
Yeah, he was 13, he's 18.
What, he's what, 19?
Cole?
Yeah.
No, he's 20, 21?
I don't think he's 19? 21 yet.
19?
He's somewhere in that area of youngness.
He's somewhere over the age of 18 and before the age of 21.
But he bowled good?
He did. His mother sent me a message with three strings to go and said he needed a 435 to catch me. I don't know what he did in the eighth, but I know in the ninth he threw a 170.
That goes a long way towards that 430.
And he had a 77 front half in the 10th. And he, fortunately for me, unfortunately for him, struggled a little bit coming home. Still bowled great. Threw a 140 string.
Yeah.
So he ended strong.
He's a good bowler.
He is. And he doesn't typically bowl well at Newport, he said.
No, because he punches a lot, he said. Splits and punches.
So he very happy for him. Mm-hmm. Again, he threw a great ball.
On the women's side, Shannon Tribner bowled great. Won that in the scratch side.
So I actually have...
You got some scores,
Timmy? I do. So I called up there last night and told them... God, that's awesome. So just outside our door is the cat box. Oh, God.
It's Tim's big cat sanctuary.
Big cat sanctuary.
It's too cold, so we brought him in.
So on the...
Hi, little kitty. Thanks for taking a dump.
On the men's side for scratch, you had Cole at 13-18, me at 13-30. On the men's handicap side, you had Mr. Bryan at 14-22. Nice job.
Thank you.
Ken Lloyd out of Bangor, I believe,
yep.
At 14-16.
Ooh.
And then you had me at 14-10.
Mm-hmm.
So I couldn't catch you.
No.
Ken bowled well. He actually went 12-66.
That's really good.
Tied Richard Beveridge for third, I believe. Mm-hmm. Richard Beveridge, junior.
Good turnout from what I saw for numbers.
Yeah. On the women's side, you had some really good bowling. Not surprising with some of these folks. Shannon Scribner, 12-36 scratch to win. I don't know if that's her first.
Second? I think third? It's her first adult singles.
Okay.
You know, when you have to battle Amanda pretty much every single bowling night of your life because they both bowl at 20.
So congratulations, Shannon.
Yes, very much. Well-deserved.
Well-deserved. And very well-deserved, Vanessa Huff. 12.08 scratch.
That's a very good
I
very
believe
good
that is her first 1200.
That's awesome.
I could be wrong.
I wonder if she beat Matt.
a little husband wife crime
maybe,
going on.
Maybe.
And congratulations to Vanessa because she did win the handicap portion for the women with a 14.18 and Amanda Dodge with 14.08.
That bowls out of 1-7-10 in Augusta.
Yep, and I think she bowled Saturday morning, maybe?
She did, because she, I believe, is with Mikey Ferland Jr.
Okay.
And Mikey bowled
so
early in the morning.
She held the lead for the entire time, up until the last shift. So, guys, great bowling all around. Saw some really great shots. You know, Oakland Park sent up some folks that had never bowled in the state tournaments before.
Mm-hmm.
I know I talked to a couple of them. They had a great time. I think they were surprised at
the quality and caliber of bowling.
Yep. And the difference between a state tournament and
a league.
And the league. So it was really cool to see. A lot of fun. Again, you know, I guess we have to come back next year to defend.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, we got in 2 weeks. We got, you know, the doubles are in Bangor in 2 weeks of Bangor Brewer.
That is correct. That is coming up the weekend of the
third and fourth. I assume you're bowling with Mr. Kaler.
As all intents and purposes, as far as I know, I am bowling with Jason.
Yeah, I'm bowling with Natty McBrien.
So we'll see. Mm-hmm. Oh, two wrestling fans bowling together.
Yeah.
You're going to throw down?
Maybe.
You're going to cut a promo?
We might go outsiders.
Nice.
little too sweet action on strikes and spares.
A little cut of promo.
Maybe.
Nice. Maybe. Who's the heel?
Oh, I gotta be. No, no. See, it's more like, it's like Vader, and I don't mean this mean, but Natty's a little dude, so it's like Vader and Harvey Whippleman. Maybe Kamala and Harvey Whippleman. I could sit there, you know. Oh,
oh my God. Harvey Whippleman. Oh, sweet baby.
Or he's
boy,
more
Jesus.
Like Orange Cassidy.
Oh my God. No, Harvey. No, no, no. I'm calling him Harvey on Thursday night. He's going to let me. What? Oh God. That's great. That's good stuff.
I actually, getting into some more bowling listener. Mr. Ryan Hogan.
Hey, oh, wait, Hoagie. Before we go any further.
Okay.
Angela Paquette, this is for you. Habs suck.
Oh, the Habs are terrible.
They are a dumpster fire of dumpsters.
And it's not even hockey season. They still stink.
Oh, my God. They're terrible.
Okay. Getting on to some bowling rosters here.
Wait. So you're just going to start naming rosters? Or are you going to actually say what this is for?
I'm going to. Hold on. I'm getting there.
Why are you yelling at me?
Man, you're old and you're upset and cranky.
I'm not upset. I'm sore.
Let me guess. It's 4 o'clock. It's past dinner time.
Oh, sweet baby Lord Jesus, am I sore.
Well, don't get old.
Oh, it's too late.
So this is for the Heather Lanes New Glasgow Open. It's going to be September 26th, so coming up.
That's in 5 days.
Yeah, it's at 9 a.m. And we have...
Are we bowling?
We are not. That's a long drive, and I don't think we're allowed there.
We're not. They don't allow us in Canada.
I don't think so. So they have 10 teams.
Is it because we're big, hairy, winning machines?
No, it's because we're from Dirty America.
Oh, we're Dirty Americans.
Yeah, we have the COVID crud.
No.
So real quick, I'll just run through these. Some of them have names. Some of them don't. There's the Turkey Hunters, Glenn Murphy, Jerry Dunn, Ryan Cox, Denise Bessent, Angela Paquette, the Habs Suck, and Narissa Crawford Daniels.
Is that their team name, Habs Suck?
That's, you know what, they're the Turkey Hunters, and I know that that's kind of a team that, a lot like PC Enterprises, that's around Nova Scotia.
Oh, yeah, no, I know.
I think we're going to change it to Habs Suck, though.
Okay, the Turkey Hunters
slash Habs
Suck. Well,
I don't know, Jerry's a Habs fan. Jerry scares me when he gets mad, so maybe we won't.
Oh, no, Habs Suck. That's team Habs Suck.
And then we have Century Honda, Trevor Stinson, Stuart Noseworthy, Malcolm Genex, Chris Cooper, Amanda Noseworthy, and Michelle Murphy. The Pocket Pounders.
Pocket Pounder, baby.
Nate Brewer, Trisha Fernell, Melissa Sinton, Jonathan Veneau, and Chad Reed. So combination Fredericton Moncton team.
Yep.
Then you have this team doesn't have a name. It's Amanda Label, Deanna Baker, Melissa Poirier, Jeff Baker, Troy Dunfrey, and Freddie Toffelmeyer. Boy, Troy throws hard.
Yeah. Kind of like me.
No. Troy could throw you that hard down the bowling alley.
I was throwing 34 yesterday.
That's good for you.
That's what I, that's it. That's good.
Then we have Doug Holloway. So I think father, son there probably. Kelly Holloway, Megan Holloway, Bernie Corbett, and Kyle Devereaux.
Is that team Hab Suck too?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
Shelly McGinnis, Gloria Dutchmean, Don Dykens, Kevin Prosper, Ryan Hogan, and Matt McDonald. So that's Hoagie's team. The Wisecracks is the next team. Kelly Mae McDonald, Junior Kevin McDonald, Shirley Jenkins, Ryan Jenkins, Alyssa Bootlier, and Adam Mugford. Some of these Canadian names are hard to pronounce. I'm sorry if I'm butchering them. Then you have the Avon Valley Lanes team. Sarah Kenny, Kayla Schwimmener, I guess. I'm sorry. The Snaz.
Snaz, Chris.
Chris Pernobzi, Jeff Dugas, Donnie Cox, and Gwinal Duguay.
Ah, Gwinal.
He's either the good twin or the evil twin, depending on which one you ask.
Well, and depending on which one, you can figure out who is who.
Well, I think Gwinal, yeah, I'm pretty sure Gwinal's left-handed.
Yes, I think so.
Yep, and the other one's right-handed.
And if not, then swap it.
I wonder if they ever just sign up for one. And then just one hangs out in the parking lot, and one gets tired. They just
the one comes in.
Comes in just bowls.
God, that'd be awesome.
We have, these are the last two. One is Splits and Giggles. Christy McNett Grandy, Brenda Berry, Laura Castle, Darren Martin, and Lucas Nickerson. And then the 10th team, man, I don't know about this team, Tim. I don't know.
This is the 10th team?
This might be a throw-together team. I don't know. Josh LeBlanc, Eric McGuigan, Jill Wood, Calvin Locke, and Natalie Stubbs. That must be Leaf Suck.
So that's actually...
Wait, they have Josh and Calvin.
Hold
so
on.
It's, it's Hab Suck slash Leaf Suck.
So there's two good bowlers on that team.
Natalie and Jill.
Natalie and Jill.
Eric Eric will have to carry the weight for the men, I guess.
Eric's definitely going to have to carry the weight. Leafs suck, Habs suck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's those are your 10 teams so far for the Heather Lane's new Glasgow Open.
Okay. Good luck, bowlers.
Yeah, good luck. Hoagie, thank you. Send me some stats when it's finished. And yeah. We'll put them on the next
stats
podcast.
Stats would be great. I like stats. So let's talk a little Outrun the Cub news.
Oh, I was reading this earlier.
So Danny Finn, Jeremy Seaholm, obviously they do it, and Caitlin Finn and more down there. They do a great job.
Yeah. I've never personally bowled in it, but I would like to.
I bowled it once, not this, but I bowled down there once in the Pro Series.
Was it the doubles?
Last September? No, it was singles.
Okay.
And really enjoyed it. I didn't bowl well, but that was on me.
How's the house? Honest?
Yeah, I thought so. I mean, I threw a 140-something my first string, and I'm like, okay, here we go. And then followed up with like a 90-something, and I missed the cut by like 20 pins, and it's just like, you know, I punched myself in the testicular
region
over and over with closed fists.
You're a bad Tim.
Bad Tim. So anyway, Danny came out with some news today. I'm going to read his post.
Okay.
Because I think it explains it better than me just talking about it. And then I'm going to rip the town of Millis after this. So, Outrun the Cub news. After talks with the Board of Health of Millis, we will have to be more strict than ever before when it comes to mask wearing. In the past, we were asking bowlers to wear a mask while seated, but not actively on the lanes. Due to circumstances we cannot control, the Millis Board of Health has stated that they want all people inside the bowling alley to wear a mask at all times, even while bowling. This is not subject to debate, as this is not a company mandate, but one made directly by the Board of Health in Millis. We understand this may affect people's desire to bowl in the upcoming Outrun the Cub tournament, so if this is an issue, I ask that you let us know sooner rather than later. This also means that if teams drop, it will unfortunately change the estimated prize fund based on the amount of teams bowling. With that being said, I feel terrible for Danny, Caitlin, and Jeremy, and the rest of the staff, because they run a fantastic place. This is absolutely, in my mind, hear me out, a bullshit rule. Absolutely 100% bullshit rule. I know of no other sport in the history of sports that makes you wear a mask such as what we have to wear for COVID, not a hockey mask or something like that, okay? Because I knew that's where you were going.
Fencing.
Okay. Are you done?
Maybe.
Okay. I know of no other sport in the history of sports that makes you wear a cloth mask or a breathable mask needed to stop the spread of COVID. Get that look off your face.
Lucha Libre wrestling.
Their mouths are open, actually. Some of them.
They're a mesh screen.
Okay, so it doesn't do a damn thing.
Just continue. I have fun busting your balls.
Oh my God. What an absolute stupid and asinine rule to make these guys go through something like this.
I agree. I don't agree with the rule. I wouldn't be one of the people who wouldn't bowl.
I have no problem mandating a mask inside, you know, going shopping inside, whatever. If you have to wear a mask inside the bowling alley, so be it. I'm okay with it. I don't necessarily agree with it. That's just personal opinion. But I'm okay with it. To make someone wear this while doing a physical activity when you're not near anyone is dumb in my mind. Okay? I feel bad for Danny and those guys.
I feel bad because it's going to turn some people away.
There were already people backing out. He put it on here. It's understandable. It just makes no sense. Like, literally makes no sense.
I think with the number of people and the situation in Massachusetts being what it is with the COVID cases,
Last I knew, they were going down.
Well, I can. I don't agree with the decision, but I can understand why they put it in. The town is trying to CYA. They're trying to cover their own ass.
Do they do it in baseball? Baseball? Some people wear masks playing baseball.
Some people do.
I've seen it, mm-hmm. but it's not mandated. Basketball? Nope. Football? Nope. Hockey? Nope.
Two of those sports are in a bubble and they're isolated.
Okay. Horse racing? Nope.
Actually, sometimes the horses do wear masks. Like when they eat, they have a food bag.
I am so gonna.
And then at night, they have to put the blinders on.
I'm gonna slap you in your one good testicle.
Well, I'm just, Tim. I don't want you to say this stuff out in public, and then people look at you weird because you're wrong.
But I'm not wrong. Not in this instance. I'm not wrong.
It's your opinion, so it's neither right nor wrong.
That's why I'm not wrong, because it's my opinion.
Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that I agree with it. It's a terrible thing. This tournament may not happen. I feel bad for Danny. I do. I'm just saying, as a bowler myself, I personally wouldn't back out. I would do the best I could to do what I need to support the tournament.
I think it's going to end up, they're going to have to postpone.
More than likely.
They're going to end up losing business. And frankly, I get that, again, Millis. Millis.
Family Amusements.
Yes. This is the town mandating this. Nowhere else in Massachusetts right now is mandating this. It's just
and like I said, I think they probably caught wind of what was going to happen. And with the number of people there, I think they put this in just for that reason. They're trying to cover their own butts.
Well, they're wrong. I don't like it. Not at all. I don't like it.
I'm not saying I like it either. I'm just saying I wouldn't pull up. I was going to say I wouldn't pull out, but damn it, Tim will come back with something on that. And I know you real well, Tim.
I know at least one time you didn't pull out.
No, that's true.
Oh, my God. Sorry, Danny.
Actually,
Jeremy.
That's tough. That's tough this close sucks. To when it was going to happen.
It just sucks. Stupid. Mm-hmm. Stupid.
I brought up something interesting on the way home yesterday that I'd kind of like to put out there.
What's up?
So next year's Men's Worlds, as we know, the knockout is Monday, November 1st.
Yep.
That means everyone's going to have to travel on Halloween. For people with kids, that's going to be tough.
I don't think it's that week.
They said they were moving it from the exact week it was this year. It's just going to be next year. And I think they already said it's going to be the first through whenever next year.
Yeah, I guess that means everybody travels on Halloween.
Davey, if you're listening, Barber, Summerton, if you're listening, strongly reconsider. Halloween, and Halloween sets up hard things because now, like, you know, us going to Bangor, we got to go through several towns.
Yeah, we're not highway driving.
Right. You're going to go through it's
town of
dark. There's going to be a lot of trick-or-treaters. God, I hope nobody gets hit. You got people coming from Massachusetts, hopefully Canada, that aren't familiar with the area. They're not going to, know where all the kids are. And plus, some guys are going to miss their kids trick-or-treating.
And I can't go trick-or-treating.
Well, I know. You and I are going to go as Donkey and Shrek, but, it's just, it's tough.
Actually, I wanted to go as,
Can we go as twins, Schwarzenegger and DeVito?
No, I was thinking that you could go as Carol Baskin dressed up in a tiger suit, and I'll go as, what's the dude's name? I can't think of his name.
I don't know.
The guy from Tiger King.
Oh,
I've never seen it. I saw something on Facebook earlier about dressing
Joe
up
Exotic?
Like that. Yeah, Joe Exotic. There it is. Yeah.
And his two husbands. Not that that's a bad thing.
No.
The husband's part's not bad. The two, that's kind of...
Yeah. Hey, so Sean Sears sent me... So obviously, I'd been asking for people's brag sheets and stuff. So he sent me the list of what they had for when they put together the...
the bracket.
The bracket and stuff. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool going through this. There's 160 bowlers on here with their high singles.
That's cool. That's a pretty good database right there.
Yeah. What do I got? What do I got here? How about anyone you want to know?
No, just shoot from the hip. Fire from the hip.
You don't want to know anyone here? Okay.
Fire from the hip.
How about we go Janet Pock? I like Janet. So Janet has a high single of 196.
It's a good single.
That's a good single.
Beats mine.
A high triple of 456. Good triple.
Mm-hmm.
High five of 735.
That's a great five.
And a high 10 of 1321.
Wow.
Yeah. Janet's done it. Janet's done a lot. Mm-hmm. And if I'm not mistaken, I think she's in the Hall of Fame, isn't she?
I believe so, yes. As rightfully deserved.
Yeah. Well, she's won a lot, too.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's kind of neat seeing some scores in here. Jason Sparks, high single 194. High triple of 472.
That's a big triple.
Big triple. That's big.
Big triple.
That's what she said. High five of 728. Does not have a high 10 listed. So I'm going to say his high 10. I'm going to make up a number. 13.
I have a
69.
I have a theory why Jason may not list a 10.
Why?
You ever seen Jason at the end of a 10-string tournament? He kind of made me not remember most of his 10s. That's
a good point. That is a valid point. Valid point. Jess Stockton, high single 181.
Very good single.
High triple 414. High five of 672. And nothing else listed. Good scores.
There's some very good scores.
Big scores in here. Trying to see if there's any surprising. I did not know this one. So Mike McIntosh.
Mm-hmm.
High single, 210.
Oh, he has a 200.
210.
That's a
not
good.
Just a 200. 210.
Wow.
Guess what his high triple is?
475.
Go higher.
480.
Go higher.
490.
Go higher.
495.
Go higher.
499.
Go higher.
500.
Go higher.
501.
Go higher.
510.
Go lower.
508.
Lower.
505.
Bingo.
Wow.
He's got a high tri- I had no idea that he had a 500 series.
That's very cool.
Not to
way
say
to go,
that
Mac.
He was. That's not. I don't want it indicated that
right.
I didn't think he was capable of it. Because he's not. But I mean, I'm just kidding. I love Mac. By the way, you ever heard him sing?
Oh yeah, Mac's great. He's great.
Holy shit, people! You need to YouTube Mike McIntosh.
Yeah, I can remember when I first met Mac. He would play at the Lita at the Lighthouse, or he'd play at the Park Place bar there.
I was floored. I had no idea the dude could sing and play the guitar like that.
Oh yeah.
But no, I had no idea he had a 500 series. So 505. 769. 769 high five and a 1333 high 10.
Wow.
So, yeah, good. We got a ton, and obviously we want to keep this going, so I'm not going to belabor the point, but we're not going to talk about everything right off the right off the get-go.
We'll do a few a week.
Oh, sweet Jesus. We haven't been recording this entire time. I'm just kidding. Just kidding. Psych.
No podcast this week, folks.
Psych. So what else do you want to talk about? What do you got?
Celtics looked reasonably good the other night.
For 3.5 quarters?
Yeah, they need to learn how to finish.
Oh, my sweet Jesus. I really thought they were blowing that. I did when they could, you know, they got it down within 5. They were up 20. And then all of a sudden they started shooting, you know, Marcus Smart shoots it from 5 feet beyond the 3-point line with 15 seconds remaining. In the shot clock.
That's not very smart, Marcus.
No, that was not.
No, not at all.
Cowboys.
I had a great weekend. Let me explain to you my weekend, Tim. I bought a truck Saturday. Well, I upgraded from my 2015 Ford to a 2020 Ford. So, got a good deal on it. So, worked out well. And then Sunday, I win the handicap singles. And then the Cowboys come back from 20 points down and win.
I
mean, 2020 may suck, but at least some things don't change and Atlanta can blow a lead. Did you see there was a guy? He bet like
$35,000
to win $1,200 and he lost.
Yep. That's called Dumas.
Mm-hmm. That's called not learning from history.
Oh, my God, no. No, that's just like...
I will say Dak looked good, and I'm not a Dak guy. I'm a big Cowboys fan.
He did look good.
But I'm not a DAC fan.
So
I'm waiting for Big Red to come in and raise some hell.
So I went to – I actually the first time in a long time, I don't remember the last time that I went to bed early mm-hmm. and didn't watch the end of a Patriots game. But I was so tired last night that I was falling asleep in my chair.
It was very, very tiring.
And so I was like, oh, you know what? I'm going to watch it up and I'll just watch it up in bed.
With your eyes closed?
No, my eyes were open at the time.
Oh, okay.
And then they were closed. And I fell asleep. And I woke up and the TV was on. And the game was obviously over because it was like, I don't know, like 1:30, 2 o'clock mm-hmm. in the morning. Shut the TV off, went back to bed. Woke up this morning. And I'm watching the news. And I'm like, holy shit, they had a chance to win that at the end.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, what the hell happened?
A lot of people are putting that on Cam.
Cam
put it called his own number.
Cam put it on Cam.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he even came out and said he made a mistake and he should have bounced it. And he chose to try to take it straight yep. through instead of bouncing it to the outside where he had a clear lane. Mm. But
Tom Brady could have done that. Tom Brady could have bounced it to a clear lane.
Clearly, Tom Brady is the GOAT.
He moves like a GOAT.
GOAT.
He moves like a 90-year-old
greatest
GOAT.
Greatest of all time.
No.
Kind of like me. No. No. I'm not the GOAT. There are lots of people better than I am.
The mule, maybe.
I could be a mule. Definitely not a GOAT. So I do want to give one shout out to someone
okay.
who actually there's a couple of shout outs because they actually made me laugh.
Okay.
I put the post on Facebook last night, congratulating you, talking about, you know, my win, yep. congratulating you, Shannon, everyone that won.
Yep.
And I got to give a shout out to Dion, which we already did.
Mm-hmm.
That was funny. But I also got to give a shout out to Chris McGrady in his comment. If you won the state championship, no way did Epstein kill himself. This is proof.
That's definitely proof.
And that is 100% true.
Yeah, do it for Jerry.
Do it for Jerry. Hashtag do it for Jerry.
Hashtag do it for Jerry. Jerry.
That's for you, Freshy. Hashtag do it for Jerry. And Chris Holt.
Oh, Chris's comment. That's funny.
Chris's one made me actually laugh.
Mm-hmm.
Not a belly laugh of, you know, pissing your pants laughing, but
right.
just enough to be like, okay, that's actually really funny.
Mm-hmm.
And his response was, this is just another testament of the shit show that is 2020. LOL, congrats, sir.
Yeah.
That was really funny. I just wanted to make
that,
sure
that
I
is that funny.
Because it was funny.
That is funny.
What else you got?
Not a lot.
No? What do you got going on this week?
Getting ready for the golf trip.
Oh, that's right. You're going golfing here in a couple weeks.
Couple weeks, yeah. 2 weeks from Saturday we leave.
Better wear a mask.
Yeah, probably will.
Don't go through the town of Millis.
I'm honestly, and this is nothing against the state of Massachusetts, but I'm not stopping in the state of Massachusetts. Because if I do and I get out of the car, I have to quarantine for 2 weeks when I get back to Maine, and that's not an option.
Well, I think you can stop it like and get gas if you had to.
I don't think you can.
I think you can.
No, I'm dead sure I don't think you can.
Like, really?
Honestly.
Are you shitting me? So if I'm getting low on gas, I can't pull over and put gas in my car?
You can, just hope to God no one finds out.
Oh, my
I think.
God, that's the stupidest thing ever.
If you get out of your car in Massachusetts, you're supposed to get a COVID test or you're supposed to quarantine for
Oh,
two
my
weeks.
Sweet Jesus. Governor Mills, stop this insanity. Think she listens?
Probably not.
You don't think so?
No, because she's probably read some of the stuff I've said about her, and then I know she doesn't listen.
Damn it, Governor Mills.
No, I just, we're planning on going, we're driving straight down. It's 8 hours. Atlantic City, playing a couple courses down there. One's called Twisted Dunes. It looks really cool. So I'm just getting ready for that. Obviously, doing the stay-at-home dad thing, toddler wrangling, all the fun stuff.
Oh, toddler wrangling. I remember those days.
Yeah, he can run now. It's fun.
I do remember those days. Now Angie has to wrangle me.
Well, you're kind of like a toddler.
I
just
am
a
like
big
a,
toddler.
I'm a big toddler.
No, other than that, just, you know, keeping up with everything. Oh, still doing the podcast on Sundays. We just did one last night. John Starner's Twitch channel, Johnny Death Drop on Twitch. We're also on Spotify now, Dudes and Belts podcast. Check that out. We just uploaded today the new episode. It's our top 10 WrestleMania matches of all time.
And mine did not make the list.
No, there's no Dino Bravo on
that
list.
Don Morocco and Dino Bravo. The French Canadian piss missile, Dino Bravo.
Jesus. Oh, God, Timmy.
God, I love being dumb.
I saw a good movie a couple weeks ago. I might have talked about it.
Yeah, you did.
Did I Tenet? Okay.
It's
a good movie.
I have not been to the movies.
It's a Christopher Nolan movie, so it's one of those, like, really messes with your mind. Like, he did The Prestige and Memento and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Inception. Sorry. Inception.
So I completely forgot what I was going to say.
Great, Tim. Very professional.
You know, I'm that way. I like to be very professional in my approach of things.
Stop stalling and remember what you were going to talk about.
Damn it. I can't. I just can't. I can't remember. So I did have this conversation yesterday.
Okay.
Things that make me laugh. And then it turned into words that make me actually laugh because I am such a child.
We had the same thing last night on the Dudes and Belts podcast because we were trying to make Rio crack. And Mark Ritchie's like, watch this. Dinkle. And fucking Rio looks like a little kid. He's like, and he just starts chuckling.
So
dinkle.
See,
it does it to you too. Kick him right in the dinkle.
Kick him right in the dinkle. So there's certain things because I am such a child.
Diarrhea.
I mean, it's funny.
When it happens to somebody else. When it happens
to someone else. But no, like, we were at the bowling alley, and I was talking to Cole, and Cole's girlfriend, and God, I can't ever remember her first name. Last name's Roy, because it's Phil's daughter. And she's probably going to kick me right in the dinkle the next time I see her.
Right in the dinkle.
Right in the dinkle. but there were things that... So... Cole said, he made the comment, he goes, dude, I thought of you the other day. He goes, I was driving and the number 69 came up. And I started laughing because I am such a child that number just makes me laugh. It's just a funny number. Because it's a 6 and it's a 9 and they overlap and you can put them together and they make just one big circle. 69.
It's a circle.
It's a circle.
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 Circle. Round. Everlasting.
So... I started laughing about it, and we got talking. I said, dude, have you ever really thought about words that just boob, like boobs? Something about the word, it makes me smile. Like, you're smiling right now. I said boobs. You started smiling.
Mm-hmm.
Fart. It makes me laugh. Oh, that's my phone. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's my boss.
Oh.
He can wait.
You're off the clock.
I'm not really because I'm salary, but
oh, well,
I'll call him when we're done.
So I speaking of things that make you laugh, I saw this the other day, and it's a new term I need to start working into my vocabulary. Goat rodeo. Goat rodeo means a goat rodeo is slang term for something going totally unbelievable, disastrously wrong, and there's nothing left to do but sit back and watch the train wreck. In other words, a goat rodeo is a chaotic situation, fiasco, or more vulgarly, a shit show. And yes, there is also a literal goat rodeo.
That's my
goat rodeo.
I think that's that's
2020 is a goat rodeo.
Goat rodeo. Yeah. Oh, I think my wife's home.
I think she is.
Yep. So it's just these types of words, they make me smile, they make me laugh. You know.
You're just a big kid at
ball
heart.
Ball sack. See, ball sack makes me laugh. Not getting punched in the ball sack. Or
no,
kicked
that's
in the
bad.
Ball sack.
That's bad. That hurts.
How about when you sit down and you sit on your nuts?
I don't do that. I'm not that old.
You've never done that?
No, but what I have done is you get ready to start bowling. You take that first step and they kind of squish together.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Then you have to stop. Because you're like, oh.
Yeah, that hurts.
Mm-hmm.
Wait till you get a little older and you sit on your balls.
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
I don't need to be that old.
God, that is painful. We're so professional.
We are professional.
Oh, nothing to see here.
Yeah, what do we got for time, Tim?
It's 5:26 p.m.
Okay, but
you want to know
how much time do we have left?
How much time we have left.
So we can start asking our...
Well, we got 40 minutes. Well, I'm not 40 minutes left. Right. We're 40 minutes in. We got about 20 minutes left. 15 to 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. By the way, folks, rippingtherackpodcast@gmail.com. Ripping the Rack Podcast on Facebook. Ripping the Rack Podcast on Twitter. Ripping the Rack Podcast on YouTube. Ripping the Rack Podcast on Anchor. Ripping the Rack Podcast on Breaker.
We're everywhere.
iHeartRadio. We're on iHeartRadio. Look us up.
Mm-hmm.
We are also on iTunes.
And Spotify.
And Spotify. Folks, reach out to us.
Tell us what you want to hear.
Tell me what you want.
What you really, really want.
I'll tell you what I want.
What I really, really want.
I wanna.
I wanna.
I wanna.
I wanna.
Oh, God. So... What is so we're coming up on the end of September. We've got
the doubles in 2 weeks.
Doubles in 2 weeks.
And no Can-Am.
No Can-Am. Nope. That's sad.
Well, the border's not open because we're dirty, dirty Americans.
No, we got no Can-Am, no Worlds.
I guess they're still gonna have the Hobbs in South
that's
Paris,
what I,
though.
I meant to find out about that because. Yeah. I hadn't heard anything about it.
That's a mixed 5-person marathon.
It's just
that doesn't know.
Yeah, it's a 5-person marathon. Mm-hmm. 14 teams typically.
All day.
All day. Fun tournament.
It is.
It's handicapped.
Mm-hmm.
It's
single
a fun,
string matches.
Yep. It's a fun tournament. I've always enjoyed it. Of course, I love bowling there anyway because
well, you grew up there.
I did. And you know. It's just kind of it's kind of fun. It's just a fun little tournament. So there is that. Peacock. That's another one that actually makes me laugh. That word.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the new station.
Well, I was. I was going to talk about the new station, but then the word peacock. It just made me.
Speaking of the Peacock station, and I saw the U.S. Open was on there. Bryson DeChambeau.
He reminds me an awful lot of me.
Why?
Because he's a big, hairy winning machine.
He's not really hairy, but he is a giant. Do you realize all his clubs are the same length?
Yeah. Yeah, he's one of those.
How do you play golf like that?
Because every club is the same length, but the lie is different. So he knows how far to hit. It's bizarre.
So you literally are trying to control every club, and you're just changing the loft.
Yeah.
I couldn't do it.
So like the driver he hits, it's like a 7-degree loft, like it's
7.5.
Yeah, it's like nothing.
He's gonna go to the max length next week. He said.
Yep.
For the driver.
Yeah, because he wants to try to hit it 390.
Yeah, he wants to try and average 390 off the tee.
Yeah. It's like okay, that's just ridiculous.
Well,
I mean,
he that's how he won the tournament this weekend.
Know.
I mean,
that was
when you're hitting driver wedge into every hole.
Yeah. And he didn't care how many fairways he hit because he was hitting it so long that.
Yeah, it didn't matter. He only had 50 yards in the rough to the fairway or to the green.
Right. Like I said, he reminds me an awful lot of me playing golf because I'm that same way.
Except you hit it about 240.
I hit it more than 240.
I don't know. We'll have to measure next time.
Yeah, I'll show you something. It's more than 240.
Millimeters doesn't count. Oh,
damn it. Damn it. So
Tiger looked horrible.
That makes me sad.
What is wrong with Jordan Spieth, by the way?
He needs to
stop playing golf for a long time, for about a year.
He just needs to take time off and just stop.
He was 14 over par in a round.
Yeah. How about Danny Lee with a nice 6-putt?
Yeah, but none of those putts were from more than like. Well, his first putt was from less than.
Putt was from 5 feet. His next putt was from 6 feet.
And the next putt was from like 13 feet.
Oh my God. And it was just like. And then he withdrew because of, quote, injury.
Yeah, his pride was hurt.
Yeah.
His pride got injured.
Yeah. I've only done that once.
What, 6-putted?
Nope. In all my years of bowling.
Oh, withdrew?
I only withdrew once.
In a tournament.
You
withdrew from the roll off there 1 year, 2 strings in.
Nope.
No, 3 strings in.
Oh, that was league. That didn't matter. We were already down like 800 pins.
You almost won.
We didn't almost win.
You guys had a chance, honestly, going to the last string. We were only up like
We were down
72 pins.
We were down like 800 pins.
Yeah, but you weren't bowling good, and your average, your dummy average was actually better. So
right,
you helped them.
So I took my dummy score.
You helped them.
Besides, it was my anniversary.
That's true.
So
That's true.
I really shouldn't have even come down to begin with, but
you thought you had a chance to win.
Yeah. No, just one time withdrew because of injury, and that was at that was a pro tour. Was it pro tour? It was either main singles or pro tour at Westport.
I had to pull out of the Can-Am three strings in a couple years ago. Pulled my hamstring really bad.
Who bowled for you?
Zach Skinner.
Did you ask me?
You were already bowling.
Oh.
That was right before Colin was born.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
That's the one Lloyd beat you
in
the playoffs. You bowled for Dad. Someone's calling you again.
I don't mind getting beat.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't. I don't mind getting, let's face it, I've lost a ton.
Mm-hmm.
We all have. I hate losing to a quarter pin hit and then completely missing the shot and making it go. And then another quarter pin hit where you beat me by one because you got an 8-pin drop.
It's bowling.
I know. And I really shouldn't complain because we've all done it.
Mm-hmm.
We have. But it just, it's, yeah.
Yeah, it happens.
It does. It just, and I like Lloyd.
Lloyd.
I like Lloyd. But I didn't like him right then.
Nah.
Because, honestly, he was also drunk.
Oh, very. That's how Magic bowls. That's his name,
and
Magic.
I just...
He's the magic lefty.
Yeah, well, he's a magic something because he was drunk and he beat me.
Mm-hmm.
And it made me sad.
Well, losing will make you sad, Tim.
That's why I'm constantly depressed.
But you don't lose. You won on Sunday.
That's right. I'm a big hairy winning machine.
So what do you want to talk about next week, Tim? We need to pick a topic so we can tell all these people what we're going
to
talk about next week.
I want our listeners to tell us what to talk about. Otherwise, they're going to listen to us talk about nothing for an entire hour.
Maybe they enjoy it. Maybe we're like, it was SMR, AMR, SMAR. What is that? The thing where like the sound of something relaxes you.
Oh, you mean like NPR?
No, there's like an actual thing. Like, hold on, I'm going to look it up. I'm not kidding.
Okay, maybe there is, but we could be like NPR. Hi. Welcome to NPR. Or welcome to Tim's Big Cat Sanctuary.
Yeah, it's right here. It's ASMR. Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response. Like, you just hear a certain sound and it just relaxes you. It's calming. So maybe people put us on for that.
That's why Angie likes to listen to me, because I calm her.
Or you help put her to sleep.
I calm. It's like, what's your name? Pam? Ham. Oh, the B is silent.
Lamb's wool.
Yeah.
Lanolin. Lanolin.
Oh, God, I love that movie.
Oh, so good. It's so good. They need to make another Anchorman. They need to make an Anchorman 2020 edition.
Except for that wasn't Anchorman.
I thought it was.
No, that's Step Brothers. When they go
we'll
to
have
the,
to check.
Nope, it's Step Brothers. When they go to the interview with the excuse me, Mrs. Human Resources lady. No, my name's Pam. Pam. Is that with two M's? Pam? Is he? Oh, I got it. Pam. Yeah, you know, Pam. Yeah, oh, the B is silent. You need to get out.
Now that I think about it, the taxes are kind of fucked up.
Onions and...
Oh God! People, tell us what to talk about, please.
Yeah, give us a list of things to talk about. Tell us what you want to know. I mean, we can't really talk about upcoming tournaments because we don't really have a whole lot.
Not going on right now,
so that makes it a little bit difficult.
Sadly, are there any? We got to find some. If there's any best boxes?
I don't even know about any best boxes coming up. That's the problem. Like
right.
There's just so little, and it sucks that we can't get across the border and those that can't come come across the board at the bowl, because it's.
I hope we can get over in February.
Oh, for the 560
bowl tournament.
I would like to think we'll be able to. My guess right now is no.
Yeah, I got to go with
the
no, probably.
That's kind of my initial.
And
my
honestly,
initial
I don't blame him. I don't blame him.
Oh, I didn't say I blamed him.
Our dirty Americans we are.
It sucks because I really wanted to bowl in that tournament.
It's fun. You bowled in it last year.
Well.
With a great group of guys.
They're a great group of guys. I wasn't planning on bowling.
That's right, you weren't.
I was not. I was coming up to.
But you had your stuff.
I did because you had mentioned, like, to bring it. And I had mentioned that I'd bring it. Maybe you guys might need someone because I was going to be up there to watch and to socialize and have fun and whatnot. And then I don't know if you made the comment that to someone that I brought my stuff. I didn't,
but maybe somebody that knew you had your stuff
maybe.
Did.
All I know is that next thing hey, Tim, oh, God, thank God you're here. We need an anger bowler for someone. Shit.
You know when they say we need an anchor bowler, you're like, oh, no.
And I was like, oh, boy, you sure my average is going to fit there? I don't know. Oh, no, we've already checked. Shit. No, and I was glad I could help out. I was. Yes. I was glad I could help out. But I was hoping to actually have a team this year.
Mm-hmm.
I had reached out to Dave Warren, and I put my name in. I'm on the waiting list.
Well, you still might have a team.
I might. Maybe you'll bowl with me.
I got to check my contract status with Chad.
Check your contract status. I'm pretty sure it says you can bowl with dirty Americans.
Well, we'll find out.
Hey, Mookie, you want to say something?
Hey, Mook.
That's good radio right there. my wife's cooking dinner.
She is.
It smells good. So we've got, I don't know, we've got like 7 or 8 minutes left.
Okay.
So we can wrap up. Talk a little bit, kibitz a little.
Okay.
I don't know what you want to talk about.
Getting ready for the doubles. Doubles coming up in a couple weeks. We got league Wednesday night. Let's hope we both.
I do.
Thursday night you have league.
Thursday night I have league.
Let's hope we do better than we. I believe we. I think
I went 3-9.
Did we take two? I think
we did.
Might
we
have got two.
We took the last string.
I don't know how, but we took it.
It was my amazing ability to make a spare shot.
But you don't bowl anchor.
I know. I was saying it was my amazing ability to throw a second ball because my first ball was shit.
Yeah, your first ball was ugly.
Oh, my God, that was ugly last
and
week.
And any time I hit anywhere remotely near the head pin, it just splattered into a bunch on this side and a bunch on that side.
You know what's cool about bowling over on that end, though?
What?
The jukebox is right there.
Yeah, the music helped.
God,
it did.
It's so much better when, like, something about Thursday nights – versus Wednesday nights down there because they're not as
well. It's the Wednesday night league downstairs that doesn't like the music.
Well, they need to because
they can't hear themselves talk and socialize.
I have no problem talking and socializing with the music.
You're also not 65 years old.
No, I'm not. I'm 49.
A lot of those people that bowl in that downstairs mixed league are of the elderly variety.
So, folks, for those of you that are still listening. You have approximately 10 and a half months before my 50th birthday. I do accept cash, Venmo me money, all sorts of things. I want to go to Vegas next year.
I do too.
I want to play golf in Vegas. I've never played golf in Vegas. I've played golf in Arizona. I want to play golf in Vegas.
I want to play Wolf Creek.
Well, you get that from me.
I looked at it, and I want to play Wolf Creek.
I know it's cool. Hey, have you played much of the 2K21 yet?
Yeah, I've played a lot of it.
Have you? I've still only played a couple of rounds.
Oh, I've played a lot.
Have you?
Mm-hmm.
It's a good game.
It is.
Someone said that there is a main course on there now.
Really?
Northport.
Somebody put Northport.
Someone created Northport, or what appears to be Northport.
Well, if it's got the shortest hole to open a golf course ever, then yeah, it's Northport.
I've never played Northport.
You can't hit driver. I can't hit driver, so I know you can't.
Well, I know York Country Club has it's a 220-yard par 3 to open.
Well, this is a par 4.
And I can't hit driver?
No.
Why?
Because you'll go over the green.
How far is it?
It's downhill.
Oh.
It's probably... It might be 320 yards downhill.
Oh, I can hit driver.
Downhill.
Like downhill, like the downhill at...
Like halfway of number 10 at Sunday River.
Oh, that was bad.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. I almost felt really bad there for a minute.
Yeah, yeah. Oh. Tim hit into a very... Well, he hit into the group in front of us off the tee box, and they were in the greenside bunker.
I didn't know.
Well, I didn't know you were going to go full John Daly either.
And it was a long ways away.
It was. It was. But, yeah, we... Yeah, I'll go home and see if I can find it. See if I can find Northport on PGA Tour 2K21.
I'm going to try to play some this week.
I'm actually going to try and create a course. I've never done it.
So I did on the other ones.
It's the same engine. So.
It just, you got to understand that a real course is going to take you 40 plus hours to really create. Hmm. I think one of the course, my favorite course that I created in the golf club, the original, took me almost 50 hours.
Wow.
To really get it.
You were doing individual rocks in the wall, weren't you?
No, I didn't go that far.
Oh, okay.
I did not go that far. I didn't worry about like the golf cart and things like that. I just wanted each hole to play a certain way. And in my mind, it was a links course. So I had, you know, It was a lot of fun. It actually got some plays.
Oh, cool.
It ended up with like 300 or 400 plays by people.
Oh, did you know if you get 300 plays on the new one, you can actually get it rated as a handicap?
Okay, then it was less than that.
Okay, but on the new one, you can. If you have more than 300 plays, they'll start rating it for a handicap.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
But I'll go home and see if I can find it.
Yeah. So, we're going to get ready to wrap up. We got a couple minutes left. You already heard my little rant on the town of Millis, board of whatever they are.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Danny, Caitlin, Jeremy. That's
rough.
It's rough, and you guys get in the shaft.
Yeah.
And not in a good way. So stick with it. You know, hopefully I can get down there at some point. And
hopefully when we're allowed to.
I'm not allowed to go to Massachusetts with my company either. Like, my company just sent a thing out on the states that I can go to where I don't have to quarantine.
Well, that's the same thing, like, at the hospital with Kelly.
Yeah.
Like, she can't stay in the same house I'm in if I go to Massachusetts, so that makes things difficult.
Yeah. Yeah, looks like I might have to get the spare bedroom ready for you.
Yeah, you might have to. I just hope you guys can all get out. I'm just going to hunker in here.
Yep, I'm good. No, I'm staying right here. Someone go.
Yeah.
Go pump gas. It is what it is, and I hate that saying, but it's truly, it is what it is. There's nothing I can do about it.
Right.
Nothing we can do about it. So, I will just simply end my little thing because I got a couple minutes here. We're coming into the end of September, beginning of October. Folks, stay with it. We only got about a month left of this because on November 4th, it's all over. Mysteriously, everything's going to end and the whole world's going to open back up again. As far as the dirty Americans are concerned, it's going to end. I'm telling you, midnight on November 3rd, when we find out who's president, it's ending one way or the other.
You honestly think we're going to know who president is after the election?
No. Because if Trump wins, if he truly wins,
mm-hmm.
then it's going to be over because the Democrats will come back and be like, okay, that didn't work. Now let's see what we can impeach him on. And they'll go that route again.
Mm-hmm.
And if Joe Biden wins, then Donald Trump is just going to
never concede.
He will never concede, and he's going to lock himself in the White House,
mm-hmm.
and he will have to be forcibly removed.
It will be like the episode of South Park where Tom Cruise is trapped in Kyle's closet
yes.
and won't come out.
Yes. And of course, if the Democrat, if Biden wins, then the pandemic's over because they've won. And don't get me wrong, folks. I know the virus is real. This is not anything to do with the virus at this point. This is about everything else that's been politicized about the virus here in the United States. For those listening abroad and elsewhere, I don't know what to tell you because I don't pay enough attention to...
America is one hell of a reality show right now.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's a goat show.
Goat rodeo.
Goat rodeo.
It's a goat rodeo.
It's a goat rodeo. So I'm going to end it, guys. Have a great week. Thank you for listening. Remember to please reach out to us.
Reach out.
Reach out. Reach out and touch.
Reach out and touch me.
Anyway, thank you kindly. Brian, you want to end it?
Have a great day. Have a great week, guys. We'll talk to you next week. Thanks for listening. Stay safe. Stay kind. And have fun.